There are so many ways to enjoy the sport of radio-controlled soaring, but one of the coolest has to be flying a really big scale glider. By definition, scale gliders are flying replicas of one of the hundreds of manned sailplane designs of the past 100 years. Some pilots enjoy the beautiful classics of the first 50 years of soaring, while others like the sexy lines and high performance of today's modern composite racers. Whatever type of glider gets your blood going, in scale soaring, no plane can be too big or too detailed. Scale glider models are usually built and designated as a fraction size of the real plane. A quarter scale glider is exactly 1/4 the dimensions of the full scale plane. Popular sizes are 1/5, 1/4, 1/3.5, 1/3, and 1/2.5 scale. The bigger the model scale, the more flying performance you tend to get, and it's easier to add scale detail. For most guys, it comes down to cost. The price to play goes up quickly with size and detail, and you may need to consider a bigger car or trailer to carry your collection of really big models. A smaller 1/5 or quarter scale glider is a good place to start for most, as they have minimal radio and servo requirements and can be flown easily with intermediate flying skills. If you have good piloting skills and a decent working budget, 1/3 scale is the way to go. Plan on upgrading your computer radio as you need lots of channels to operate extra features like the retract wheel and brake, spoilers, tow release, and landing flaps. You can easily go out and buy high quality, almost ready to fly molded planes, and most of the classic pre-World War II gliders are available as wood kits. There's also an active used scale plane market, and picking up a used glider is an inexpensive way to get into scale soaring. Vintage gliders of any size tend to fly like trainers, but the newer, higher performance ships are very efficient, and you have to have some experience flying planes that glide fast and forever. There are many ways to get your scale plane into the air. You can aerotow your glider to thermal altitude, or you can slope fly off a cliff or a ridge. Alpine thermal soaring with large scale planes is very popular in Europe, but most guys don't have access to such sites or the nerve to chuck a 30-pound glider into a bottomless valley. Electric motor assistance is the next big thing, and you can either put a powerful brushless motor in the nose or use one of the new up-and-go retractable systems. A good motor and lithium battery setup will cost you a bit up front, but having electric power will free you from having to have a tow plane winch system or slope handy. Aerotowing is still the most accessible and popular way to launch big planes to thermal altitude. Aerotowing uses a powered RC aircraft to tow the glider up, closely emulating the technique that manned gliders use to get airborne. You can aerotow at any flat flying field, and towing is easy to learn and set up. The hardest part is deciding who has to fly the powered tow plane instead of the glider. The gas-powered plane is called a tug, and it's either a scale replica of a real glider tow plane, or a specialized design customized for the fast and efficient towing of large-scale gliders. Most tugs use either a 2- or 4-stroke model airplane engine, sized to give the tug tons of extra pulling power. Each tug has a releasable tow line hardpoint and large landing flaps. The flaps allow the plane to get down quickly from altitude, which cuts down the towing turnaround time drastically. Lithium polymer battery-powered electric tugs are coming onto the scene, with the advantage of being quiet, powerful, reliable, and pollution-free. Gas power still has the advantage at large events where the towing goes on all day at a high rate, but electric power is perfect for smaller groups of flyers. If you are looking to get into scale soaring and want to find out more information on techniques and scheduled events, get on the internet. Virtually every scale-oriented club, organization, and airframe dealer is on the web. You will quickly learn about what to buy, how to build, and where to fly. The best way to experience scale soaring is to attend one of the many scale soaring events held each year both in Europe and in North America. In North America, the premier scale event is the JR Aerotow, held usually the first weekend of June. Sponsored by JR Radios and Horizon Hobby, this event hosts over 50 pilots over 4 days at a private full-scale airfield run by the local soaring club. At this big event, you will see some of the biggest, baddest scale planes flown by professional-grade pilots. Although the caliber of planes and pilots is high, this is a laid-back event that encourages beginners and intermediate pilots to attend. It's a perfect opportunity to hone your flying skills and accrue lots of towing experience. Now let's go to the JR Aerotow event to experience the best scale Soaring has to offer. Mornings are really busy, with pilots assembling and repairing their planes for a full day of flying. Particularly impressive at this event is the spacious hangar completely filled with over $100,000 worth of the finest scale gliders. About half of the pilots registered are from the West Coast, mainly because Horizon Hobby will ship your gliders back and forth for free. Without this service, most could not get their big planes to the event safely. The tow planes get serviced and fueled. They will be very busy with about 100 tows to do each day. With two or three tugs running at all times, there's a very little wait time for tows, so you can fly all you want until dark. Just grab your frequency pin and cue up your plane on the ramp.
Get everyone lined up and we'll get you up in the air.
At an event this big, you are sure to see a full day's worth of spectacular flying by some really big planes, flown by the sport's top pilots.
Buzzing is normal.
Settling. Okay,
on.
still shaking, Paul? Can you see
it? Yeah, we're here.
Put that leg strap back on.
Thank you.
go to the glider club. So much support is appreciated. Come on over and see me, and I'll give you raffle tickets right away.
Thank you.
Pro modeler Chris Lash brought his super cool 1/3 scale Horton Parabola to the event for some more flight testing. This huge hunk of foam and fiberglass is a replica of one of the Horton brothers' radical glider designs of the 1930s. The full-size Parabola never flew, but Chris has proven that indeed this radical design would fly, even though it is a real handful in the air, as you will soon see. Watch closely on the first landing as the Horton yaw suddenly towards me, the photographer, and misses my head by only inches. When viewed frame by frame, you can see just how close the Horton passes by. If you have great thermal conditions all day in the Midwest, chances are you will pay for that great lift with lightning and buckets of rain in the afternoon. That's exactly what happened every day. There's always a last-minute mad dash to get the plane's hangar before the monsoon hits full force. If you can't fly outside, you can always practice your soaring inside on a laptop flight simulator. Wireless internet connections are really useful at an event like this. Real-time Doppler radar images piped into the hangar showed everyone exactly when we could go flying again, which was going to be real soon.
Thank you. Thank you.